accounting students and those of you wishing to learn more about accounting. This is the first video in our merchandise inventory series, and we're going to be looking at FIFO, which stands for first in, first out, a method of inventory valuation. Now it will give us a way to value what we sold and a way to value what we still have left. Now, what I want to stress to you about all of these inventory valuation methods that we're looking at, these are ways to measure what we have left and what we sold. It is not necessarily the true indication of physical flow of goods. It's a theoretical method. Okay, so this is not necessarily the true physical flow of goods. That's very important for you to understand. So let's go ahead and look at FIFO, first in, first out, method of valuing our cost of goods sold as well as what we have left in our ending inventory. So here I've set up a spreadsheet for you for one of our products. And you see that on July the 1st, we had one item left in ending inventory at that point. So we started July the 1st with one unit from June. And that unit cost us $40. So that's what we have at the beginning of July. Then on July the 5th, we bought six more items of this same product. But now, as prices tend to do, they are increasing. So now we're paying $45 a piece for each of those six items for a total cost of $270. Then if you scroll all the way over to our inventory on hand, which is also our ending inventory, we still have that one unit from our beginning inventory on July the 1st at $40 for that one item. And now we have six more items at $45 each. So now we have a total ending inventory of $310, which is the $40 from the one item and the $270 from the six items. But notice in those last three columns, I'm keeping the different value of inventory separate. So the one item at $40 is separate from the six items at $45. That's going to be important when we start selling items like we do on July the 15th. So on July the 15th, we actually sold four items, but because we're using the first in, first out method of inventory valuation, we start with our beginning inventory. Well, the beginning inventory only had one item, so that's not enough to fulfill the order. But we are going to theoretically sell that one item, which cost $40, and then we're going to need to go grab three from that purchase on July the 5th. And they each cost us $45. So we've sold four units here. We don't really know what we sold them for because this spreadsheet does not tell us what revenues are. It's only a cost sheet. So please make sure you understand that. Revenues are not depicted here at all. So we sold four items. The total cost of that sale was $175, which is the $40 for the one item from beginning and $135 from the three from the July the 5th purchase. So now we have three items left in our ending inventory. We have none left theoretically from our beginning inventory. And we have three left from that July the 5th purchase of six at $45. So three of those at $45 leaves us $135 in our ending inventory. Then on July the 26th, we made another purchase. Again, as prices tend to do, they're going up again. So we bought seven items this time, and each one of those cost us $50 a piece. So now in our ending inventory, we have three items left from that July the 5th purchase, and we now have those seven from the current purchase at $50 a piece. So now in ending inventory, we have 10 total items, three at $45 and seven at $50, for a total cost of our ending inventory of $485. Then on July the 31st, the end of the month, we sold eight items. Again, we go to our oldest stuff first because we're using first in, first out. We don't have anything left from beginning, but we have three left from that July the 5th purchase. So now you're starting to see how important it is to stay organized with this stuff. So we're going to take the three we have left from the July the 5th purchase at $45, and we need five more. So we're going to take those five from the July the 26th purchase. So we're selling eight items for a total of $385 in cost of that item, and we still have two items left now in our ending inventory from the July the 26th purchase at $50 each. So all of our beginning is theoretically gone. All of that purchase from July the 5th is theoretically gone, and five of the items from the July the 26th purchase are gone. Now we'll start August the 1st with beginning inventory of two units at $50 each. Okay, so now let's let you try one. So let's assume that an RK toy store bought and sold a line of dolls during December as follows. So we have our beginning inventory. We have 14 units at $10 each. Then we sold 8 units. Then we purchased 15 at $15 each. And then we sold 13 units. So we're going to say that we don't have any dates here, but we'll just assume that they happened in that order, whatever the date may be. So RK Toys uses the perpetual inventory system. Compute the cost of ending inventory and cost of goods sold under FIFO, first in, first out. So what I'd like for you to do is give this a shot. Press pause on your player. And once you've completed the problem, come back and we'll take a look at it together. Okay, so what you should have found for ending inventory would be $120 at the end of these transactions, and your cost of goods sold for this period of time would have been $245. So if you look at my spreadsheet here, you'll see that we started the period with 14 units that cost us $10 each. We sold 8 units. They all have to come from beginning because that's all we have. So 8 at $10 gives me that cost of goods sold of $80. Then my inventory on hand at that point would be 6 at 10, so all of those coming from beginning. Then we bought 15 more at $15 because as things typically do, prices rise. So now we've got 6 left from beginning inventory at $10 each, and now we have 15 more that cost us $15 each. Then we made a sale of 13, again, because we're using FIFO, first in, first out. We have to use the oldest stuff first. So we go all the way back to beginning inventory, and we still have 6 left from beginning inventory. So we can theoretically sell all of those, but we still need 7 more. So we're going to need 7 from that first purchase there of 15 at 15, and that will give us the total cost of that sale. And we still have 8 left from that purchase that we made. And so that leaves us inventory on hand, those eight units at $15 each, which equals $120, and the total cost of goods sold, we would add up that whole column of cost of goods sold, and that gives us $245. Okay, so let's try one more. This one's got a little more stuff in it that we're going to deal with. We have Unfit World. They began January with an inventory of 60 crates of vitamins that cost a total of $3,000. During the month, Unfit World purchased and sold merchandise on account as follows. So this time we have purchases and we have our sales amount. So we sold, like the first sale, we sold 180 crates at $100 each. That's our revenue. Remember what I told you about the inventory spreadsheet? Revenues do not appear there. So we must be going to do something else, maybe some journal entries here in a second or something. So we may need that information for something else, but it does not go in our cost sheet. All right, so Unfit World uses the FIFO method, so we're still on first in, first out. Cash payments on account totaled $5,000. Operating expenses for the month were $2,400, with 2/3 paid in cash and the rest accrued as accounts payable. We need to compute total purchases, cost of goods sold, and ending inventory for Unfit World. Okay, so once again, press pause on your player. Give this one a shot. Once you've computed the two amounts, come back and we'll take a look, see how you did. Okay, so the key here, again, is to stay organized with your spreadsheet. And if you do, you should come out with something similar to what I have here. You should have found that your ending inventory, you would end up with 10 units at $60 each. All those came from that second purchase that you made. So a total of ending inventory of $600. Your total cost of goods sold for this period would be $19,100, and your total purchases would have been $16,700. So once you have your spreadsheet set up and your cost of goods sold calculated, you actually have to get this into your books. So we need to journalize all the transactions here using the FIFO costing method. So now that you've got this in your notes, we want to journalize these transactions. So we want to journalize the purchase, the sale, purchase 2, and sale 2. So let's just start with purchase 1. So we purchased inventory a total of $7,700. We can actually just look at the spreadsheet here and go right down through there. We purchased $7,700 on account, so we would debit inventory and credit accounts payable. The next transaction was a sale. Recall that every sale has two transactions. We have to record the revenue and record the cost. So if it's sold on account, we would debit accounts receivable and credit sales revenue for the amount that we charged for our product. And then we would also record the cost by debiting cost of goods sold and reducing our inventory. Since it's no longer there, we've now sold it. The next transaction was purchase number two. Here, we're buying inventory, so we're debiting inventory for the $9,000, crediting accounts payable for the $9,000. Sale number two will look very similar to sale number one. And we had a sale, so there's two transactions. We debit accounts receivable for $17,600, credit sales revenue for $17,600, but then we also have to record the cost and reduce our inventory. So we debit cost of goods sold, credit inventory for $9,500. The next two entries, they tell us that we paid on account $5,000. So we debit our accounts payable and credit our cash. We're paying toward our debt. The next transaction was towards your operating expenses. It said that a certain portion of them were paid in cash and the rest was on account. Two-thirds of that was paid in cash. So operating expenses were $2,400. Two-thirds of that is $1,600. So we credit cash for $1,600. The remainder of that would be credited to accounts payable. Don't forget, if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, and questions and comments are always welcome.